So, recent press release by Tesla and Elon. Starting next year, 2017, all Tesla vehicles sold will have limited supercharging capabilities. So it looks like the few have ruined it again for the many. The original intent of the supercharging network was for long-distance travel, not for your average resident to go and charge up at a supercharger instead of charging at home. Hogging up the spaces, taking up space, so long-distance travelers have to wait and wait forever while Joe Schmo gets a 100% charge to save a dollar at a supercharger. Basically, the deal is if you make your purchase before January 1st, 2017, you will still get the unlimited supercharging as long as you also take delivery of your vehicle before April 1st of 2017. So basically, why is Tesla doing this? Basically, to reduce consumption and congestion caused by locals and deter taxi companies and limousine companies from hogging up supercharging locations. And I've witnessed this myself. I can say one example is Highland Park, Illinois. I'm not there very often, but I'd say every time I've been there, except in the middle of the night, like 3 a.m., to supercharge, they have four stalls on two superchargers, so it is power split. At least one or two of the vehicles sitting on those one of those four stalls has been either a Uber driver, a taxi, or a limousine, private limousine company using up the space. And I mean, I've seen as much as all four stalls there filled. And then we got Madison, Wisconsin, three stalls and constantly filled by locals in Madison, even ones that have at-home charging, just trying to get a few free electrons. I could see one thing is if you go there and you plug in, go walk the mall and you're shopping anyways, but just going out of your way just to use it up, a week ago, we had a four car wait to charge up at Madison, and some were even completely full. So I think, from that standpoint, a move to a paid structure of some sort is an excellent idea. Since, I mean, obviously they can't build stations fast enough to cope with that kind of use, especially once they start producing the Model 3 and that huge influx of people come in. On the other hand, it is going to have some impact for those that do lots of road trips, like myself. I'm lucky I do have an unlimited supercharging car because it is free for the life of the vehicle. So you're not, if you have it already for unlimited supercharging, you will continue to have it unlimited for the remainder of your vehicle's life. So for someone that does a lot of road tripping, it is going to cost you. You're going to get 400 kilowatt hours of supercharging power per year for free, and then after that, you will have to pay. And that replenishes every year on January 1st or however, whatever their replenishment date they set will be. So that and heavy supercharger users, will impact. You will have to pay. But Tesla also did say they are going to charge a reasonable price. They don't want this to be a profit center. They want this to be more of a deterrent for habitual users that just don't need to be using it. The original intent of the cars were to charge at home, not spend all your time charging at a supercharger. Now, obviously, some people don't have the option to charge at home, for like those that live in an apartment building or a condo. However, I have been seeing lots of law changes kind of forcing apartment building owners and condo associations to that must approve installation of charging, not necessarily them paying for it. The owner of the vehicle or whoever owns the condo or whoever's driving the car would have to pay for it. But
that is being changed. And a lot of areas, I think Chicago's or Illinois is one of them. California's got the law. So that is a good thing. You should be charging at home. Now, they said prices for the charging at Superchargers will fluctuate. That means up and down. It doesn't just mean up. Obviously, depending on utility rates, the price for supercharging could go up, but it could also go down. Think about it. What was another one of Tesla's goals? To have all the superchargers solar powered. So now that Tesla's acquiring Solar City, that is going to be even closer to a reality. I mean, places like Tion Ranch, they have the solar canopies. Well, obviously, the size of the solar canopy is not big enough to cover all charging. It's a great start. And right now, their goal is to get the supercharging network built and then start filling it in with solar. So, could start high and then start going down lower. So maybe once the supercharging network is or almost entirely solar powered, the cost for the power is going to drop considerably. And maybe they'll only charge a penny or two per kilowatt hour just to cover the maintenance of the stations and fund ongoing expansion of them. So, I mean, it might not be the end of the world. I mean, if you can charge an entire 100 kilowatt pack for a buck, come on. That's enough to go 300 miles. Let's see. Value of the older cars. If you have a car that already has unlimited supercharging capability, that remember, that's going away. There's still going to be taxi companies and limousine companies and Uber drivers, all those people that's, and even people that do drive or commute an excessive distance, or people like Bjorn that use theirs for Nimber. I'm just having fun with you, Bjorn. That need that, or really could use that unlimited supercharging capability. That means the value of your unlimited supercharging car just skyrocketed. The chances of the value on a lot of the Model S's have been holding very well. Now your value of your used vehicle might actually appreciate instead of depreciate, especially if it's in excellent condition or easily refurbished back to like new condition down the road. So keep your used vehicle great if you're looking at selling it in the future. Now it's going to have a downside. One of the things that Elon had mentioned about the fully autonomous cars is their ability to be part of the future Tesla ride sharing network, where you could just, when you're not using your car, you can just send it off and let it make you some revenue. Well, unless you make your purchase before the end of 2016, you can kiss your unlimited ride-sharing revenue goodbye as your autonomous ride-sharing car won't be able to get that unlimited power. So if you were looking just to buy a Model S or Model 3 or Model X just for that, now is the time to get your Model S or X to do that, because remember, everything as of middle of October onward has the full autonomous hardware in it. Hopefully that's enough. And they don't decide to make another hardware change to really bring the full autonomy to it, driving down the road by itself with nobody in the car at all. So, of course, as usual, the abuse by some has ruined it for all. And like I said, the original intent of the supercharging network was for long-distance travel. So locals and businesses just abusing the heck out of these networks has brought this upon themselves and the rest of us. I do think the 400 kilowatt hour a year is pretty fair. I probably would have said 800 would be a little better. I mean, they could increase it in the future. Or give maybe holiday bonuses for well-behaved people, or maybe they'll allow just like rollover minutes for phones, cell phones, rollover kilowatts from year to year. Say 1 year you don't really use it, you only use maybe 50 kilowatt hours of supercharging, so then they might let you maybe carry over 350 from a previous year, or maybe you could trade with friends. I mean, this really could open up a whole bunch of ideas down the line. But, I mean, just like some have ruined it, autopilot for us by hopping in their back seat while they're creaming down the highway at 75 miles an hour has really ruined and soured autopilot experience for the rest of us. That is what has now happened to the Supercharger network. But that 400 kilowatt hours a year, that's approximately, based on rated range, that's approximately 1,000 to about 1,200 miles per year, or just a hair under 2,000 kilometers per year. So for most, that's enough to cover most road trips. I'm seeing most drivers don't really even use the supercharging network very much, but it's just that few that do. So... in the end, you know, what are your thoughts on this change? Do you think this is a good change, necessary? Do you think this is going to hurt Tesla? Give us your thoughts below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I pray Bjorn's Model X lasts a very long time, because I don't know what would happen to him if he would have to replace that his unlimited supercharging with one that is limited. So Bjorn, take care of that blue baby of yours, Optimus Prime. And don't forget, comment below. And if you are in the market for a Model S or a Model X and want to get in before the change to limited supercharging, please consider using my referral code to get your $1,000 off. The link is in the description box below. And if you do use my referral code, please contact me and tell me you did. I'll put your name in the hat, so if we get enough referrals to go to the next Tesla event, I'll pull your name out of the hat. And if your name gets pulled out of the people that use my referral code, you will be my plus one or plus two or whatever to get into said events. So, see you all next video.